In this video, I'm going to show you how to fix the automatic repair loop in Windows 10. So there are a lot of reasons why you can get this screen. It could be something with your hardware. It could be something with the application that you've installed or an installation that was interrupted, for example. And in the end, you will get a screen like this. So the automatic repair screen. And the first thing that's maybe quite obvious that you can do is to shut down your computer and to try it again. Maybe remove some hardware and just restart your system. But I assume that you already did that and that's why you found this video. So what we're going to do now is we're going to talk about three different methods. So if restarting your system didn't work for you, we can go to the second method. And we're going to try the startup repair tool. And to go to that tool, you can select advanced options on the screen over here. Okay, and now you go to troubleshoot. Advanced options again, and here you will see the startup repair. So you go to the startup repair and you will see a screen like mine, and you just need to wait till this is done. So it can take quite some time. It can take an hour, might be shorter, but if it takes way too long, this option is not going to work for you. So then you can try the next method that I'm going to show you. So just wait till this is done, and if the startup repair tool didn't work for you, you can go back to the screen and then you go to troubleshoot, advanced options, and here you will see the command prompt, and that's our third method that we are going to try. So select the command prompt and then you will see a screen like this. So first we need to select the disk where your operation is installed. So most of the time this is your C drive, but it could also be a D drive. Or insert the letter of your drive and add the colon symbol. Hit the enter button and now you insert DIR. And now you will see the program files. And because of that, you know that you selected the right disk. So before we're going to do the whackback comment, we're going to make a backup in case we need to restore the system. So to do that, you insert CD space backward slash Windows backward slash system32. Backward slash config and you hit enter. Then you insert MD space backup and you hit enter. Now you insert copy space asterisk dot asterisk space backup. And because I already used this solution, I need to override my existing backup. So I insert the A. And now you insert CD space whackback and you hit the enter. And after that, you insert DIR and you hit the enter. And now you will see a couple of different files. And this step is really important. Next to the files, there needs to be a number with maybe 6, 7 or sometimes 9 digits. So where you see the 0 at mine, there should be a longer number. So you need to be really careful at this step. If you see a 0 like I do, you need to exit this step and then try the last method that I'm going to tell you. If you see a longer number with digits, then you can insert the following comment. Copy space asterisk dot asterisk space dot dot and you hit enter. And again, because I already used this solution, I got a different message, but it should look like this. So it asks if you want to override the default, and here you insert the letter A and you hit the enter. And after that, we can leave the command prompt by inserting exit and you hit the enter. So now you can select continue and start up your Windows machine. If for some reason this didn't work, you can also try to make a bootable USB with Windows 10. And I will make a video about that in the coming week, and I will add a link in the description. So I hope this fixed your error. If it was the case, please leave a like. If you have another solution, please let me know in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.